solve. 8 is less than 16 minus 4x is less than or equal to 36. This is called a double inequality because it has two inequalities. You solve it in the same manner as an equation or an inequality, and that is you try to isolate this term with x, and then you do what is necessary to get the x by itself. So the first thing we're going to do is subtract 16 so that we can get rid of the 16 here, leaving us with negative 4x. Let's make some lines here. These are like the barriers, like the equal sign, and these are inequalities. So if we subtract 16 here, we have to subtract 16 in every part, on every side of those barriers. So we'll do that. Subtract 16. 8 minus 16 then leaves us with negative 8. And in the middle, we have negative 4x left. And on the right side, we have 36 minus 16 is 20. The inequalities stay the same. We have a less than and a less than or equal to. Now we're going to isolate the variable, get x by itself. So divide everything by negative 4. And remember those barriers. Everything is divided by negative 4. Remember with inequalities, when you multiply or divide by a negative number, as we are here, we're going to change the direction of the inequality. And that's going to happen on both of these. So we're going to write as a result here, positive 2 is greater than x is greater than or equal to negative 5. I think it's a little easier always going from lowest to greatest. So I'm going to rewrite that as negative 5 is less than or equal to, because the point is pointing at the negative 5 here, x, and again the point is pointing at the x, is less than 2. So we've just reversed the order here and then reversed the order of the inequalities. So that's our solution. So x is somewhere in between negative 5, including negative 5, and 2. Another way to write that would be including, that's the square bracket, negative 5, comma, 2. So it's all those numbers that are greater than or equal to negative 5 and less than 2. So that's another way to write that. Also, we can use a number line. So let's do that. Let's show this. Let's see, negative 5, and we're going to use a number line going up to positive 2. Let's put a 0, let's say, here, and a 2 here. And where are we going to shade this? Well, it's between negative 5 and 2, so I'm going to use a blue here and say a closed circle because 5 is included, an open, I'm sorry, negative 5 is included, an open circle at positive 2 because positive 2 is not included. It's strictly less than positive 2, and then shade everything in between. So that's another way to visualize our solution. All of the values in between here and including negative 5 are solutions to this double inequality.